the courage to face your future and forget about the past. Hope gives you courage, and God gives you strength to fight on. Fight on one more day.
Hope in God gives you the courage to face your future and forget about the past.
Hope gives you courage, and God gives you strength.
Well, welcome to Joshua's House for Christian Artists. I'm your host, SMR, Apostle Dr. Lois Sulyans-Gibson, up here in Big Sky Country, Billings, Montana. Hallelujah! It's 59 degrees. I'm raining outside. The grass is green. But I thank God I still got my spot and I'm comfortable at. I want to welcome our guests from New Orleans. Lord have mercy. Jay Reed, pastor. I'm going to read a little bit of his bio because I suggest you go on his website and you'll learn a whole lot more about him. He's a native New Orleans. He's best known as a gospel recording artist, but has an extensive resume singing R&B, classic soul, and love ballads. He began singing at his local church as a child, later traveled with and sing in Tyler Perry musicals. Man, I know those must have been some funny situations in Tyler Perry musical to have that type of training. And with all those anointed artists, my God, you can probably write a book about it later on. Hallelujah. He began singing at his local church as a child. And like I said, in travel with Tyler Perry music. He was twice nominated for the Gospel Music Stellar Awards and has won several other music awards, including the Rhythm of Gospel Award, New Orleans Viewer's Choice Award, the Big Easy Award in 2019, the Gulf Coast Gospel Music Award, Male Vocalist of the Year. He has four Gospels CDs to his credit. And that's where we get ready to take a journey through this music. Anointed for Purpose, Stellar Award nominated, self-titled, Jay Reed, three songs from my heart. His latest project scheduled to be released is already released. Two singles, The Journey, I Trust the Lord, and Testimony. And we're going to talk about several of those songs because I'm telling you, I thank God for, like I've explained to your Bruce for promoting, I said, I don't select you guys. It's the Holy Spirit that leads me to you. And I thank God when the Lord had led me to you, I was dealing with, and I'm still dealing with, you know, one while I couldn't even talk. The attack was so heavy, and all I could do was I had to have my leaders run the different programs. And I just did the Zoom part because I had no voice, but we were still on. And as I listened to your music and another artist who's coming on this next week, Shonda Inglis, the spirit in the music, God was speaking to me through. And it just ministered to my spirit. It just uplifted me, took me on a journey, like I said. And that's why when Bruce was talking about those are old songs, they may be old to him, but to me and my listeners, they're new. And because I never knew of you. And see, that's why I thank God for the internet, because it's allowing us to tap into people we would have never have met, except for those leading us to. And I thank God for your various songs. Like I said, it ministered to me, and I know it's going to minister to my fans that watch it, because my videos go around the world. You know, we just rebirth after 10 years because I had to make sure, because we used to do blog talk, and I had to make sure the quality and the Holy Ghost party would be the same. Because basically, we sit down and we celebrate our Christian lifestyle. We ain't dead. We're just on the right side of the track. Hallelujah. You know what I mean? And it's excitement and the songs are the testimonies. And for what we're about to go through in this next season coming in after late June, God is not playing. He's sending out the sound. It's a clarion call to get ready. There's another major shift coming. But if you don't have music to keep your mind in perfect peace, and you don't have none inside of you, or you can't wreck that mess, shut up, I'm not saying, and go into that, you're going to be lost. Because this next wave is coming to take people's minds.
Yes.
But he's saying, if you're anchored on the rock with me, you're going to be fine. Because the first wave was that pandemic. And he said, go into the ark of safety. Those that went in said, okay, we good. And those that just thought, oh, no, this can't be happening, their hearts failed. You know, yeah. They gave up, you know, and when they couldn't do anything else but just lay there, some of them died, you know, because some of the stories I was hearing about some of the family members and the people working inside some of the place, there was nobody to really pray for them, encourage them. Even some of the people that came through was telling, if it wasn't for God speaking to them, they wouldn't have came back through. So that was the first way.
Yes. This
one that's definitely coming to take your mind, because he said what he said. He said, I will never send another flood. But it's allowing other things to come because we keep forgetting to play our position as believers of Christ. You want to get caught up in the Scooby-Doo and the Looney Tunes of this world. And that's why when it comes, you don't know what to do. But thank God for us, the remnant that's hanging in there and preparing. So we're going to start with your first song. And it's a good way to start. Hallelujah. Let's talk about smile. I'm reminded of Proverbs 15 and 13 that says, a heart full of joy and goodness makes a cheerful face, but when a heart is full of sadness, the spirit is crushed.
That song is so special. Actually, that song was birthed during the pandemic.
Ooh. And
We recorded a video during the pandemic, and that video itself was just to really encourage people through everything that we were going through. And of course, the world being shut down. And around that time, of course, we were looking at, you know, we'd just gone through the period of, you know, the presidential riot and all of those different things that was going on around us. You know, that song was birthed out of that time to let people know, you know, it only takes 1 second to smile and say hello. And one smile can change a person's entire disposition. It could change their whole world. You don't know what people have to fight and struggle through.
Yes.
And the last thing people need is somebody to be mean mugging them.
Ooh,
and
Jesus.
Especially Christians, we are supposed to be the ones that have the joy of the Lord in our hearts. And we have a responsibility to share and to spread the joy of the Lord. And sometimes only comes through a smile. A smile speaks volumes, sometimes more than words do. And so that song was birthed during that particular time to just encourage people to smile and to, again, give God the praise for all that he has done, you know, and not just what he has done, but when we think about what he's going to do, we all have a reason to smile.
Amen. When I heard smile, I said, oh man, let us get going here. And that's because a lot of my friends tell me, they call me a social butterfly. I said, yeah, because it's like, how you doing? Praise the Lord. You know what I mean? I'm excited. I woke up. I'm free. I may be slow but steady, but I'm able to get out there and enjoy the day because the greatest gift that he has left us is the ability to wake up. What you do with that day is on you. And you're going to let people cross your boundaries? That's on you. You're going to sit up there and hold resentment and anger? That's on you. Remember, God gives free will. I'm excited. You want to stay stuck on super baby? Come right ahead. Praise the Lord. I'll be down there. Fight that much. You know what I mean?
You know, it only takes 1 second to smile and say hello. Why be so mean? Check it out.
People in this world can be so cruel, always trying to tear each other down and acting time it's winding down. The way you treat each other today will soon come back around.
I'm different, you're different. People use that as an excuse just to be mean. But we live in a world of differences, and that's what makes the world a beautiful place to be. Take some time and smile. It's not hard.
Okay. Another thing I wanted to talk about, all your different songs, they got some excellent intros. Let me tell you, I'm an intro kid. Because if they got the intro good, I'm like, oh, I mean, each one just took me. I'm like, all right now, that's what I'm talking about. You got some people that don't have good intros. Let's talk about your next song, Honor Belongs.
Right like that. I love praise and worship. Praise and worship is my heart, and so my son Kevin Lambton, which produced that particular project with that song on it, he introduced that song to me, and I absolutely fell in love with it, and say we must do that one, because we know that all honor and glory belongs to God. Without Him, we are nothing. It's in Him that we live, we move, and we have our very being. So all of the honor and all of the glory goes back to Him.
Give you honor.
Honor belongs to you, oh Lord, we give you honor.
All praise belongs to you, oh Lord, we give you praise.
All praise belongs to you, oh Lord, we give you praise.
Honor belongs to you, oh Lord, we give you honor.
Honor belongs to you, oh Lord, we give you honor.
All praise belongs to you, oh Lord, we give you praise.
All praise belongs to you, oh Lord, we give you praise.
Well,
you
marvel.
Righteous, magnificent in all your ways. Honor belongs to you, oh Lord, we give you the praise.
Oh, 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 oh.
Let's talk about your next song. Oh, man, when I heard this one, I just rocked with it. Anointed Me. Because you've been anointed, appointed, and authorized to cause an attack in the enemy's camp. Tell us about that testimony.
Anointed Me. That song was penned, oh God, so many years ago. Actually, that was the song that was nominated for a Gospel Stellar Award. And I think that song, again, it really spoke to the life of many believers to understand that, you know, God has anointed all of us with purpose in mind. All of us have a purpose and a plan that has been designed by God. And so that song was so special because it spoke a lot about my childhood, you know, where I came from. And in spite of all of that, God still had a plan for my life. And so Anointed Me is a very, very special song to me.
Amen. Amen. I thank God for that song, too, because it just pepped me up. It just listen, it does not matter what we go through, because that's part of the process. You know, I have a motto, no punks on the front line. Baby, I ain't no punk. So I can stand on that front line. You got some people that the first wave, they getting wiped out because they never allowed the Holy Spirit to perfect and get cleaned up from all those old stupid mindsets that they used to use to protect them. Now I got the Holy Ghost protect me. I listen and I say, okay, no problem. You know, everything that I do now, I just say, okay, Holy Ghost. Sometimes he'd be telling me stuff. I said, well, you need to explain. That's kind of jacked up now. And he'll say it to me real simple. And I'm like, oh, okay. I remember there was a season when, before I relocated from New York to this Abraham journey, and I had some new people had came. I said, Holy Spirit, I don't want nobody else right now. I want to start preparing to make this downsizing everything to go to Montana. So I got a Holy Ghost. What do the sheep do when there's no shepherd? I said, okay, no problem. You know what I mean? Straight like that. It was like, it was no debate about it. What do they do? No, I'm not going to have no more. And they turned out to be such a blessing, even to this day, even though I'm here and they're there. Matter of fact, I'll be seeing them in August. But yeah, so that's how our spirit talks. He talks to us all differently. Man, I'm straight. Get to the bottom line. What's the bottom line? What do the sheep do when there's no shepherd?
Wow.
Only a fool would have sat up there and been a stupid and not take the two sheep.
Absolutely.
Who am I? Woe is me.
Woe is me.
There is something so differently. So don't get caught up looking at me.
Looking at me.
But greater is He that lives in me.
Yes.
Yeah. So when you see me
doing my thing,
just remember it's in Jesus' name. I often wonder why
He chose me, a wretch, and dumb, but He decided to use me.
Now I understand it's not about me,
it's not about me,
but it's all to His glory.
Yes. Ooh, yeah.
Just an ordinary person with God's favor and purpose, He decided. I'm just an ordinary person with God's favor and purpose, He decided.
I'm just an ordinary person with
God's favor and purpose,
He
decided.
Your next song, Secret Place blessed me with Bishop Lester.
Bishop Lester Love is, he now serves as the third presiding bishop, of the Full Gospel Baptist Fellowship. Of course, we know that Bishop Paul Morton was started the Full Gospel Fellowship movement, which is now taken over by Bishop Walker. And so
Hezekiah Walker?
Joseph Walker, right? Okay. He's out of Nashville.
Okay.
Yes, he's out of Nashville. And he took over after Bishop Morton retired. Bishop Love is a son of Bishop Morton. And we are longtime friends. We actually came through the trenches of ministry together in the very, very early years of his ministry and in my ministry as well at Greater St. Stephen's.
Amen.
Morton. And again, we've just been longtime friends. And a friend of mine, actually, Timothy Young out of Pensacola, Florida, wrote that song. And I called Bishop and I told him, I think that this would be a great song for you to come and do with me. And it, I mean, just we came in the studio, and I mean, immediately our kindred spirits united on this song, and it has blessed so many people.
Yes.
Yeah, Secret Place.
Yes. Wait a minute. Now I remember Bishop Lester. He does the love songs.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
A couple years ago when I heard him, I said, all right, now, that's right. He just changed the words to who he, that's right. And then to see half the congregation get up there, amen. We just change who we serve now. Amen. All right now. Yeah, Secret Place was another piece that allowed me to just to heal as well.
Psalm 91 says that he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I have to be in that secret place.
In this place, I feel your presence surrounding me. In this place is where I find liberty. There are people all around, but there's still only you and me in this place, the secret place.
In this place, I feel your presence surrounding me. In this place is where I'd find liberty. There are people all around, but there's still only you and me in this place. Secret place. Hell.
In this place, I feel your presence.
It's surrounding me.
This place is where I find liberty.
Yeah,
there are people all around,
but there's still
only you and me in this place.
Secret place.
Secret place.
Where I find my peace of mind.
in that place where it ain't nobody but me and you, Lord. I may be surrounded by people, but ain't nobody there but me and you, Lord. Whether I'm in a church full of people, or I'm driving by myself in my car, I gotta find you, Lord. I gotta find you, Lord. I gotta find you. I gotta find you. I gotta find you.
Just like the next one, miracles. Because, see, I was looking, and I'm still claiming my supernatural. I still claiming my supernatural healing, that all this gonna, this too shall pass. There ain't no doubt about it. But in the meantime, I'm still doing my assignment.
That's it. That's it.
So tell us about miracles.
Allow us to go through different things in our lives. Most of all, again, as a believer, to see how we will respond.
Amen.
Of a trial, you know, how will you respond? Will you still complete and do your assignment even when you're not feeling well?
Amen.
In your body? I know for me personally, myself, many times, many days, I've not felt my best, but it is in my assignment, in doing my assignment, that I receive what I need from God. I receive.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's important that we continue. And we know that he is the God of miracles.
Yes.
He is the God of wonders. That song was written by a dear friend of mine, Danielle Garner. And again, that was another song. When I heard it immediately, it connected with my spirit, because he is truly a God of miracles. If you want to see a miracle,
amen.
Just look.
Listen, there's two right here. Hallelujah.
We can do big
miracles. Oh yes, he can work miracles.
My God, oh, works miracles. Oh yes, he can.
Oh, I'm a living witness that he can work a miracle. Talk about the next one. There's joy in serving God. Come on now. That was, I tell you, that it was so simple. That's right. I don't know why people think there's no joy in serving him. When you sit back and look at what he's done,
absolutely.
You know what I mean? How he's allowed you to go through some stuff so some things could fall off in you, so that you can learn to depend on him at all times. I tell many of the leaders I pour into, listen, all he said, my sheep know my voice and they obey. All he wants you to do is know his voice, the correct voice. I said, because a little while there won't be no internet, no radio, or anything else. And who are you going to be listening to if you haven't already fine-tuned your ear to hear the right sound? You know what I mean? Because there's joy in serving him. So what was happening with you that you came out with this? Because the beat and everything was all that's right. It's excitement.
Joy in serving God, actually, it was written by the late, great Thomas Whitfield. Yes. And it was a song actually that was written for a very, very well-known choir here in the city of New Orleans, the New Orleans Gospel Soul Children. Mm-hmm. They recorded that song back in the early 80s. I was a very young boy when I first heard that song. And many, many years later, I had an opportunity as an adult to sing the song with them. Mm-hmm. The previous leader that led the song, she had a transition and went on to be with the Lord. And so as an adult, I had an opportunity to lead the song with the choir, and it blessed me. So I of course got the permission to record it and then, you know, put my own little spin on it. And yeah, and that song too has just been great. Actually, when Bruce told me, he mentioned some of the songs that you wanted to talk about, it really took me back as well. I was like, mm-hmm. wow. And I went back and listened to some of those songs. And honestly, it blessed me because, you know, sometimes when you record so much music, mm-hmm. sometimes you don't really listen to yourself, of course. Mm-hmm. And then you forget, you know, some of the songs that you have recorded. And I spoke with you earlier this week. I was headed to Houston. And so on the drive, I happened to go on YouTube and I just sit and pulled up a lot of the songs that I've recorded over the years. And I was like, wow, that was a great song. And Joy in Serving God was definitely one of my number one picks.
Amen. Amen. And because, like I said, these songs are not old. Because Bruce has, like I said, Bruce has said these songs are old. And when he said that, because he said it with another artist before me, I said, man, let me tell the Holy Ghost told me to tell you. That's what they said about the word, but the revelation is different now.
So, Bruce.
Yes.
So for me, as a new kid hearing this stuff, this, like I said, it ministered. And like God said, watch this next wave. You need music like this for this next wave y'all going to go. If you have, because there's a lot of the music that they're making now, it's not, for me, it's not heartfelt. Mm, real testimony stuff. See me, I thrive on the testimony people. Really, you can feel it and you pick it up automatically. You know, you can sit there and you can cry. It automatically hits your spirit, your heart. You're like, oh, yes. And it, like you said, takes you back. And you had a resume. You got a resume of goodies. Amen. about hope in God?
Hope in God. That was, again, another song. You know, it was at some point in my artistry journey, you know, as I matured, I began to really trust other people to introduce music to me. You know, I got to a season where I didn't want to totally have creative control. I wanted to allow other people to be able to pour in some of ideas and some of their music. And actually, again, that was a song that was written by my son, Kevin. And Hope in God is one of my favorite songs. Actually, it was during the George,
Floyd?
The young, that was George Floyd, yeah, the one that was killed by the police officer. That song, during that time, we re-released it as a single. And we had gotten, but only through, you know, through social media platforms, YouTube, Facebook, et cetera. And we had gotten such a response off that particular song because it ministered to people for that time that we were in. You know what I'm saying? The Bible instructs us not to put our trust, our hope in man, but trust in God only.
Amen.
Hope solely in God. Amen. So that is very, very special. As you said, I mean, there are some songs, again, that we can consider to be old. But again, it just like the Word of God, you know, we can read the same scripture over and over and over again. And each time God can give us a fresh revelation on what that particular scripture is saying.
Hallelujah.
Particular in your life.
That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's one of those songs, Hope in God.
Amen. Amen. Now let's
go. Hope in God gives you the courage to face your future and forget about the past. Hope gives you courage, and God gives you strength to fight on. Fight on one more day.
Hope in God gives you the courage. Forget about the past.
Hope gives you courage, and God gives you strength to fight on. Fight on one more day. Keep on to make it through this journey. Keep on to fight one more day. Oh,
hope gives you courage,
and God gives you strength to fight on.
Courage.
this journey
one more day.
Keep holding on, keep holding on
one more day.
One more day, I can almost see the end.
One more day.
Now let's go on to the next one. When I heard this one, I don't know who did it with you, but I love what it said. Job's story, not your permanent station or position in life. You have to go through the fire, the flame. You have to go through the storm. I heard that. I had to put that on repeat because that was real. That's real. Not your permanent station. Hallelujah.
Yes, 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 yes. Job's story, actually, now it's been 26 plus years. As a young man, I was diagnosed with early prostate cancer.
Wow.
And that was a journey. That was a journey. And that song, actually, I never forget, I was on tour in France, and when I first started having symptoms, that song just dropped in my spirit. And yeah, going through that journey, the Lord allowed me to record that song. And honestly, it was just in the studio that all of that came together. I had not fully completed the song. So that song was very organic during that time, because what I did in the studio is literally what winded up on that particular recording. And so it was just fired by God.
Mm-hmm. You can tell it. You can tell it. Because like I said, the lyrics alone, because that's right. It's not a permanent station or positions in life. You know what I mean? You know, everybody's got to be tested. You know, some people make it through the fire and some people punk out.
That's it.
And that's what it's about. You know what it is? You got to be a doer of the word, not the lip doers. He needs the real doers.
Yes.
You know? And you have to be that living example to other people. They can look at you and say, you what? Yeah. Ain't God good? He did it for me. He can do it for you. You know what I mean? How can you sit up there and encourage somebody if you haven't been through some of this stuff?
Been through nothing. That's it.
Exactly.
You know? Your testimony is what you have gone through.
Yes.
You know, and not something that you have an opinion about. It's something that
come on now.
God absolutely has no respect for person, and certainly if he did it for me, if he was able to deliver me and bring me from that,
yes,
you know, and he can do the same for you and all of us. If the truth be told, we all have a Job story.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Job was a man that loved God, but it seems that he lost everything that he had. And I'm reminded of a particular verse, Job 14. He asked the question, if a man die, shall he live again? And the response came back, all the days of my appointed time will I wait until my change come. So my friends, you may be experiencing your stormy hour, but I came to encourage you today to let you know, wherever you find yourself, that's not your permanent station, that's not your permanent destination. So I want to encourage you today to continue to look unto the hills from which cometh your help, knowing that your help cometh from the Lord. So listen, my friend, it's not time to give up. It's not time to throw in the towel. In life, we find ourselves in three positions. Either we're entering a storm, or we're in the midst of a storm, or we've just come out of a storm. So listen, my friend, wherever you find yourself, know that God is standing right there for you. Know that He has your back in every situation you go through. For the Bible reminds us that He wished above all things that we prosper and be in good health, even as our souls prosper. So my friend, listen, know that it's only a test to build your testimony. So what you need to do is keep pushing, keep pressing, and stand on the word of God. My prayer is that God will give you peace in the midst of your storm, knowing that you're coming out with the answers. This is
all your troubles away.
I have to go through.
Wave your problems away. Yeah, yeah. Say bye 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 bye.
Amen. Now let's talk about the light. How did you get that one?
Oh, man. You know, as a kid, one of my favorite songs growing up in church was Walking the Light, Beautiful okay. Light. Come, do drop the mercy, shine bright. Yeah, and so that song, again, I came together with one of my producers, and I told him, I said, man, I got this idea. And we just sit down and began to work on the song together. And yeah, that song actually is one of my favorites, too. I like the groove. That's kind of, you know, I guess my R&B roots.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Inspired on that. Yeah.
But it works. It works. Now let's
God is the light. We're just the light. Simply a reflection of the real light that shining all so bright. God is the light. We're just the light. Simply a reflection of the real light that shining all so bright.
God is the light.
Shine down on me.
Now let's talk about your last song. Man, I think when I started pushing a lot of your stuff and different scriptures, that's one of them I keep adding to it. Testimony. Oh, I like the intro and everything. That's a hot song, Testimony.
Yeah, Testimony, man. I mean, it's crazy because, you know, as you said, I mean, you were not familiar with my ministry prior to recently. And I mean, I've been out here for a long time. The Lord has blessed me through the years to be able to, you know, do full-time ministry, full-time music for now almost 30 years. And so God has allowed me to have some great, great experiences. And you know, of course, when I transitioned into pastoring, which now actually I'm celebrating 14 years.
God bless you.
Yeah, I'm celebrating pastoring actually next week. My ministry turns 14 years next week. And of course, going through that transition of coming out of, you know, just being a musician now into, of course, now shepherding God's people. It was a huge transition.
Yes.
You know, too much is given, much is required. So, you know, I tried to teeter-totter for a minute, you know, and say, okay, well, I'll just kind of pastor during the week and I'll still travel on the weekends. And like you said, the voice, the Holy Ghost will arrest you. And, you know, God, and he said, no, there's a season now that you need to shift your attention, your focus. And so in obedience to God, I came off the road. I just kind of shut down the whole music thing for, you know, a couple of years to really, you know, focus in on my ministry and what God was doing in my life as it relates to that particular part of my life. And so, you know, I went off the scene for a little while. And so Testimony actually came. We worked on Testimony during the pandemic as well. And we actually did a soft release on that song during the pandemic. But of course, you know, everybody was distracted, of course, and just really trying to do life, you know, and trying to accept that new norm. You know, my mother also transitioned during that time. And so it was just a really difficult time for me. And so we did a soft release on the song. And so I just kind of pulled it off the shelf and for a minute. And, you know, once I came out of that survival mode, you know, because I think we all kind of in some way, in some sense, you know, switched into survival mode during the pandemic. And so once, you know, coming out of that particular time, you know, I connected with Bruce and I said, I think I'm ready. I think I'm ready. I think this is a song, again, that speaks to every person's life, not only the believer, but even non-believers. If you are still here and you made it through the pandemic, you have a testimony.
Amen.
Millions didn't make it.
They sure didn't. Yes.
Grateful to God that you are one of the ones that did. And so for all of us, we have a testimony. You know, in that song, I consistently say, I'm still here. I'm still here. And the mercy of God. One thing that we should not ever take for granted is God's grace and his mercy. The Bible said they're new, brand new morning by every morning. He gives us brand new mercy, brand new grace. And like you said, now he blesses us with the gift of giving us another day. It is what you do with that day.
That's right.
That is all up to you. That's one of my high pick favorites right now.
Yeah, I'm like I said, I didn't know that you had been on a shutdown with the Lord and music. You see how the Holy Ghost just brings you in. So I'm gonna do my part to get you on out, because like I said, it ministers, your music ministers. I thank God for how he uses the various people to come to Joshua's house, because if I can't eat it, I'm not feeding it to nobody. You know, yeah. And yeah. I have some people that be sending me music that have sent me music, and they keep forgetting that when I drop it on my system, if you don't own the music or you're not legally to the music, somebody else's name appear. And right. I had a couple of artists do that, and I asked them, is this your music?
Mm.
Okay, and they hum the hum, and I said, listen, I got to guard this ministry. You're not going to put me in the middle of any craziness that you don't own, and I'm pushing you into somebody else. And see, that's why, you know, I thank God for wisdom, you know, the equipment he's given me to make sure. We're a small ministry, but we're powerful. And we don't get caught up in Scooby-Doo because we nosy. We got to invest. I say FBI, faith, believe, investigate. I investigate everything. I go to people's pages and see who's who before I connect with you. I don't need to have strange fire being attached to me. It ain't happening. I mean, listen, I'm an OG, a youthful 67. I got plenty of things to do. So I don't need all these little counterfeits trying to come on and suck out my anointing. Because I tell my leaders all the time, I ain't wasting my oil. I need it for me. I don't mind. But am I going to waste it for you? If you're not ready to move, when I'm ready to move, well, you go right ahead because apostle going on. No, it's what it is. You know what I mean? I love them to death. But look, your lack will not be my lack.
Mm.
I've been in this too long. I've been in this since 1999. In a New York State prison, and I took my last hit of crack cocaine was I was raised as a fifth generation white witch, didn't know God, college, had my own business, was a veteran, but unbeknown to me, the enemy had somebody assigned to me. I married a man that was a down low brother. I waited till I was 36 years old to get married. I found this out and didn't know Christ, who could I tell the shame and guilt to? I felt like a failure, even though I had accomplished all these things. But I was also a child that was told at six they weren't wanted. So that took me through crack cocaine 15 years. And then I said to God, if you real, clean me up from this crack, I'll go anywhere and do anything for you.
Jesus.
In the 4 years I spent in prison, I got my PhD in Jesus. I was in the strongholds. I birthed 8 ministries in there. That's when I come out, I tell people real quick, baby, you go ahead. I ain't playing with you because you don't want what I can release.
Mm.
In the prisons, they have some radical sold out for Christ because we had time to sit, get gutted out, work on them issues. You know, we found Christ in there, the power of the blood in there. I remember when I came to Christ, and then the lady came through. I was strictly in the word, and I got filled with the Holy Ghost. I was drunk in the spirit for 3 days.
My God.
You know what I mean? So that's why I tell a lot of these so-called men, talk about, well, women ain't supposed to be there. I said, well, you go tell that to God. Because he called me, and I know what he called me for. You know, I'm not intimidated with anybody.
Oh, he has qualified, justified. That's it. Yeah.
And then, like I said, since when is there a gender in God, in the spirit? You know, that's why I tell people, know the word so nobody can't come with this slick woolly stuff trying to manipulate and make you feel less than. I've been delivered from the bum of rejection.
Yes.
Low self-esteem, low self-worth, misplaced anger, you know, power control. I don't need none of them jokers. I sit up there real quick and say, listen, the word says, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. And baby, let me tell you, daddy gonna wax you better than I ever could. Have a good day.
Whoa, I'm still here, y'all. My life
is a testimony to show somebody they can make it, cause I made it, yeah. My life is a testimony to show somebody they can make it, cause I made it, yeah.
So let's talk about your talk show you have. Let's talk about it with Jay Reed. Tell us about that.
I believe that that we should, utilize every gift that God has given to us. I was telling my church last night, I said, when the Lord decides to call me home, I want to make sure that I'm rusted out. I want to die empty because it is said that one of the richest places in the world is in the graveyard, where people have died just full with, dreams and ambitions and goals. And so let's start it with Jay Reed is a talk show that I birthed on last year. And so actually we are almost about a year strong now. And it is a YouTube and Facebook platform talk show where, again,
why the enemy
all
messing
walks
with you?
Of life.
Okay, you got to do that all over again. Start again.
I bring guests on from all walks of life to just tell their story. I had to kind of clarify with people, this is not a gospel show. And of course, we bring, ministers on but I tell them my... if I'm going to bring on a minister, it has to be a minister with a real story.
I know that's right.
I believe that, people, especially as it relates to people, pastors and the fivefold just alike, I believe that it is critically important that we live in a way where people are able to identify.
Amen.
Tell people our real story. The truth is, we have not always been where we are now.
That's right.
And be told, we're still all a work in progress.
Amen. Amen.
And so my show, we have had, people from all walks of life that come on, people that basically showing people how to turn their tragedies into triumphs. Showing people how to turn their pain into purpose. And again, if God did it for them, it's somebody out there that can relate to the story. I've had women, two women in particularly that came on my show that were well-established women. There was one young lady that came on my show. She was a millionaire. And she fell into some trouble and winded up going to prison, lost everything. But again, with all of that, she was able to turn that trap in her life into purpose, for another young lady, her prison experience totally changed the trajectory of her life. It showed her what her real purpose was.
Amen.
I'm saying, and that was again. Now, so now she has a program where she helps and houses formerly incarcerated
women. Hallelujah! That's what I'm talking about.
What the enemy meant for evil,
yes,
and turn it around and make it work.
Yes.
I am so proud of that show and what the Lord is allowing us to do with that platform, because again, it's a blessing to people to be able to tune in and watch someone that has a story that they're able to identify with.
It's not over till God says it's over. That's what that's all about right there. Hallelujah. I loved about those women. That's right. Listen, one of the things I always tell people, when you're delivered, you're transparent.
That's it.
Okay?
Yeah.
If you ain't delivered, you're not transparent. And then I'm a no, because it's called a peek-a-boo. We see you. Y'all think y'all doing something that nobody knows. Trust me, we know.
Yeah.
The whole attitude is different. I've been encouraging people all the time. I don't care what people know about me. I'm known as Apostle CPP for crack the prison to the pulpit. So, and what?
That's it. That's it.
Who would have ever thought? And I broke the line of the witches.
Mm-hmm.
So I thank God. And before we get off, I want to ask you about Voodoo Land down there. How are the churches handling all that down in there?
Well, you know, we are known as the city of voodoo hoodoo. But, you know, of course, as believers, we are covered, you know, and, you know, I believe, you know, that voodoo is just like faith. You know, I mean, anything that you truly believe, you know, again, can manifest in your life. You know, if you have faith in a thing, your faith is what causes manifestation to happen in your life. And I believe that voodoo is the same thing. You know what I'm saying? People that truly believe in that, you know, that is something that can truly manifest in your life. I know that there is a world mm-hmm. that exists. Mm-hmm. Of course, we know that we live, you know, in a world of wickedness and yes. and high places and that sort of thing. But, you know, it is something that I believe wholeheartedly, you know, as a believer, you know, the Bible says you can't curse, you know, what God.
That's right.
You know, and certainly you can't bless what God has cursed. So, you know, if somebody call themselves doing voodoo on me, I know that. You can't curse what God has blessed. I'm blessed.
Right. I know that's right.
I'm blessed in the city and in the field, so I don't care what you're trying to do.
Go no weapon. I know that's right. I remember when Katrina came, and I asked the Holy Ghost, I said, Holy Ghost, why did you allow it to happen like that? He said, because I've been telling them for all this time, clean up. They got wild. They lost their mind. So I had to release the water. I said, ooh.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And it's amazing. You could ask the Holy Ghost, he's going to tell you something. Like when the pandemic came, I said, well, Holy Ghost, what was this about? He said, I kept telling them who I am. He said, but I decided to let them see who I am.
That's it.
When were borders shut down around the world?
Yes. I tell people that I believe wholeheartedly, Apostle, that, you know, the pandemic was really for the believers.
Oh, yeah.
Because I believe that God had to shut down the physical building mm-hmm. because the church was out of order.
Oh,
and
yeah. Oh,
was
yeah.
not doing what the church was called to do.
Exactly.
And so, you know, God had to shake up some stuff. He had to shake up his people and get us back in line. And so, you know, and like you said, the weak and the faint in heart didn't survive. And I believe also that God had to clean out some things.
Yes.
God had
to clean out some
things. Even in the church, you know, I mean, we see that a lot of the older generals have died off. That's because God was shifting some things. God was shifting some things. God has a remnant of people that he's trying to bring to the forefront that have probably would have never had an opportunity to get to the forefront if these generals would still be in place.
Well, see, Pastor E, you using the same corn I was. I said, God, why are all these generals dying off? Here go the Holy Ghost. I told them to pass the baton, but they want to hold on to it. I said, oh. So yeah. I'm telling you, what do you say? He gave us our comforter, our God, our advocate. Ask the question. I be asking the Holy Ghost all the time. I know he be laughing when I be coming. I know he be mm-hmm. laughing because I'm going to get the 411 because I want to know, you know, because I'm not in this to lose this. I'm in this to win this and make sure I stay in position, you know. Yes. But yeah, that's why I said this next wave, he says, coming through. It's a lot of people going to die off because of fear.
Yeah.
Like you said, first of all, there is no new norm. There never was a new norm. The world is built on trauma.
Yes.
We have to get healed up of all these various traumas, learning how to allow the Holy Spirit to clean us out, to recognize it, to work on it so that it don't keep us bogged down. That's that extra weight you get. Nah, listen, I'm a voluptuous woman of God. I ain't going to carry no more weight than I got.
That's all right. Voluptuous is in.
You know, but it's I thank you, Pastor Reed. I had an awesome time talking with you.
Absolutely.
The goodness. A real transparent leader in the community. God bless you with your sheep that you got. Because I'm telling you, being a pastor ain't no joke. I thank God he gave me, I'm a pastor to leaders. And me, I don't have to be so kind to them. Y'all at a certain point, it's time to cut the nonsense. I said, if you was a baby, I would baby you. But listen, you are an evangelist, a prophet, a bishop, a listen, no, let go of that bully spirit. You need to let go of that. Because I got to make a call to somebody now about something that they did. And they ain't going to like it. But I'm the only one that will come and confront the apostle. Because I called them out on it. Yeah, you got some issues. You need to go sit down and rest. You're in burnout and you're spewing it on the people. No. And I always tell the person that keeps calling me, I said, remember when you had me, how did I treat you? I said, I stand on the scripture. With loving kindness have I drawn thee. That's how God drew me. That's how I'm able to deal with my leaders. I give you the word. The Lord give me a word for you. I say, hey, the Lord told me to tell you this, yada, yada, yada. Boom, talk to you later. Ain't no conversation because I give you in detail what he said. Now, you know, and they say it all the time, Apostle, I tell you, you be dropping it and then you don't give us no conversation. Well, what? That ain't my business. I'm just giving you what he said. You know what you got to do. Now, you want to stay stuck on stupid, get beat up. That's on you. I don't care because I'm not getting beat up.
That's it.
You know what I mean? I even text them, email them.
That's it. And that's to release the word. That's it.
This is not about my ministry. It's about the ministry.
Yes.
Many parts, one body.
Time after time,
I think about it.
Day after day,
I want to shout it.
All that you've done for me, you've set my soul free, and now I am well.
You